when you think of the best Toyota off-roaders in history, one may think of the Land Cruiser, the 4Runner, Tundra, Tacoma, FJ Cruiser. But one vehicle that most people don't think of, maybe due to lack of familiarity, is the Toyota Mega Cruiser. Because on this week's episode of Toyota History Tuesday, we're going to be talking about this unique and rare vehicle. I mean, look at this thing. This was made by Toyota. This is not a Hummer H1. This is a Toyota vehicle. So the prototype of this vehicle was debuted in 1993 at the Tokyo Motor Show, the 30th to take place. Production would start in late 1995, and the stylization of this vehicle was inspired heavily by the Hummer H1. Sales began in 1996, but for the Japanese market only. So let's talk about the specs of this dynamo. This was a four-door, full-sized SUV, as you may guess. It had a 4.1-liter inline-four engine, interestingly, that was a turbocharged diesel engine. Although only having 153 horsepower, it had 282 foot-pounds of torque. It was linked to a four-speed automatic transmission with a two-speed transfer case. And of course, definitely four-wheel drive. With having a wheelbase of 134 inches, it was over 200 inches long. With having a wheelbase of 134 inches, it was 200 inches in overall length. It was 82 inches high, 85 inches long. It had a curb weight of 6,283 pounds. It had front, center, and rear differentials that were all locking. It had an optional center tire pressure system that would allow you to refill your tires as you were driving the vehicle. With a hardtop roof, it could sit a total of 6 passengers. They were all made in Japanese standard right-hand steering wheel construction, with only 12 being made in left-handed orientations. And this vehicle was meant to implement test market features for Toyota's more mainstream sports utility vehicles. There were two versions of it, the BXD10 and the BXD20. The BXD10 was the lion's share of this vehicle, and they would almost entirely be made for the Japanese Armed Forces and the Japanese Self-Defense Forces. The BXD20 would be used for fire departments, police departments, and some of which would be sold to civilians. There is an estimate that between 133 and 149 total mega cruisers were designed for civilian consumption. And that's of a 3,000 total number of these vehicles produced. In comparison to its inspiration, the Hummer H1, it was 16 inches longer and 7 inches taller, but 1 inch narrower. It had a massive 2-meter wide cargo area with a cargo load capacity of 1,323 pounds. And rare for the time, and especially rare for vehicles of today, it had a fold down tailgate, which had a fold away staircase. It had leather and wood upholstery, car phones, and several screens within. It had a total diameter of 37 inch tires, around 17 inches of ground clearance, double wishbone suspension with a sway bar connecting the two front corners. Much better than the Hummer H1, it had an 18.4 foot turn radius, which the Hummer H1 had a 26 foot turn radius. And that number, the 18.4 feet, is better than a lot of modern trucks. The engine was called the 15BFT and allegedly got 22 miles to the gallon combined, which made up a 28.5 gallon gas tank. It could drive up to at least 81 miles per hour. It had four-wheel steering and inboard brakes. It uniquely had portal axles, and interestingly was also 1,000 pounds lighter than the Hummer H1. The diameter of the wheel itself was just 17.5 inches. The engine was known to be pretty darn loud, but was reported to not handle like a military Jeep or a military vehicle, but handled much more like the Toyota pickup of the time. It drove pretty darn smoothly. Quick side note, the only other vehicle in Toyota's lineup that would use the 15BFT engine would be the Toyota Coaster minibus. So that's pretty awesome that a vehicle meant, at least partially for civilian consumption, had a bus engine in it. It was sold at the modern equivalent of $90,000. But unfortunately, this was not a financial success for Toyota. It was intended, of course, to test those SUV characteristics, but with only 3,000 units sold over a model run of 1996 to 2002, the reasons for its discontinuation were cited as slow sales, mostly due to result of vehicle taxation in Japan and thin Japanese streets that couldn't accommodate a vehicle of this size. That being said, this off-roading supercar, basically, is a model by Toyota that very, very few people know about, but it is one of the most capable off-road all-terrain type vehicles that Toyota has ever made. So, kudos to the Mega Cruiser. Kudos to Toyota for creating a vehicle like this. I would love to see a turbo diesel V6 version of the Tacoma. Let's see it. Come on, Toyota, come on. Well, thank you so much for watching. My name is Mitchell. I'm here at Fred Haas Toyota Country, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks a lot.